Hey everybody, back again with another episode on my journey to building my dream home. So in this episode, I wanted to go over kind of the design process of kind of coming up with the concept of what I wanted to build and why, and kind of how we refined that and who I hired to help me with some professional help to try to figure out exactly what I want. So, you know, as I mentioned in the first episode, really what I was looking for is essentially like a two-bedroom apartment above three bays of shop space. A place where I can tinker and work on cars, different projects, be able to kind of have a little fun and just be able to drop downstairs to work on current things that I'm looking to do. So I started off actually looking at a bunch of online plans for, you know, carriage houses. So people that are very rich that actually have three car garages that build apartments and lofts above those three car garages as some design ideas. So I was looking at some of those, taking a look at some of the kind of the designs and the layouts. You know, they kind of had different bedrooms on either side of a living area on top of those, and then the three kind of bays at the bottom, you know, and a door on the one side. And it's kind of a common layout across them all. Trying to find those with two bedrooms was okay, but trying to find them two bedrooms with two bathrooms, that was a little harder. So, you know, it's one of the things that, while I liked the space that we had for the two bedroom apartment, we only had one bathroom. Olivia is becoming a teenager, has more bathroom time getting ready and stuff like that. So wanted to kind of have some more bathroom space. So overall, at the end goal, when we get to the end of the design, you'll see that we ended up with three bathrooms in the design. But started off looking at those. But you know, those that know me, I like to do things a little different. Maybe a little bit more difficult, maybe a little bit more off the wall, something that kind of stands out. So I started looking at more designs, small home designs that are a little more funky. And I came across this one design that was a single car garage that had kind of a funky roof lines that would come together to create this neat shape. And on the one side of the upstairs, kind of the whole upstairs side of it, was a balcony that was over top of the garage space. And I really liked the shape and the feel of the house. It had a very kind of contemporary modern feel to it, which I've been kind of, you know, leaning towards more. Kind of most of the rest of my previous decorating has been kind of more of a traditional classical wainscoting and things along those lines. So for this time, I'm looking to try to do something that's a little bit more sleek lines. So I found this funky design, but I was looking at it thinking, was there any way that I could modify this kind of look to get the three bays that I was going for? So it had a kitchen on the main floor to begin with, and I thought, okay, well, what if I expanded this out into the same kind of concept of this upstairs balcony spot, kind of like what I had on my condo. I had could walk out onto a balcony looking out and being able to kind of sit out there in the mornings. My lot's got a lot of southern exposure, so I'll get a lot of morning sun that will come across there. And so I started designing it with three bays and moving all of the kitchen and everything up onto the main top floor. So kind of had that as, you know, did some photoshopping of it to try to see what it would look like from the outside, and was really kind of looking the feel and how kind of the clay model was starting to, you know, come together there. So at that point, you know, I thought, okay, I've got something that I think I really like visually. It's got a funky feel to it. It's got lots of glass, lots of windows. For me, January and February are a struggle with lack of sunlight, so I want as much windows as possible into the building. So at that point, I started looking around to try to find an architect. Talked to a few different people, and eventually ended up talking to Gabriel at Geometra Designs out of Toronto, and I found him on Houzz. Actually, it was a He had a lot of high recommendations, and you know, I talked to a lot of other architects, and they were just all about, you know, no, have you thought about this? What about that? What about these negative sorts of things? And it was, I just felt, you know, I want someone in my corner around what I'm trying to achieve. And so when I started talking to Gabriel, it was this instant kind of, you know, connection there that, you know, he wanted to know, I wanted to understand what my goals were. How do I want to, you know, live there for the rest of my life, which I want to, right? And what are my hobbies, and why did I want to design it in this way? And what does it look like, and what does it mean to me? And trying to work from that aspect. And so it was a, you know, hit it off right away. So started to work with Gabriel to actually start and design more from my Photoshops and the things that I had as a starting point, and how could we massage that into something that was better. So, you know, we first parts on that was really starting to find the position on the lot, right, and where north was in all of those things. So his first suggestion was to flip the design. I had, you know, when you came in, the door was on the right side going up and the three bays on the left, and we flipped those over more because of where sunshine and light was going to come into the building based off of how it was positioned, you know, for where the sun would come up and rise and set. So that was the first step of flipping those things and starting to take a look at then, you know, just kind of some of the floor plan layouts and revising those. Looking at, you know, how do we create, you know, this sense of space and sizing, and getting some kind of quick block renders to see, you know, an elevation drawing, to be able to see kind of in 3D space the blocking and sizing, and how would that feel. So he had made some different, you know, quick designs in SketchUp for me to get a sense of the space. And we made sure that we had, you know, we could start feeling what it was like with the cathedral ceilings, all kind of, I think on the one side was like 17 feet, the other side was about 15 feet high, with these sloping roofs, and it had this great feel to it. So we had a kind of where we were wanting to go, but one of the challenges that we ran into was that my lot is so small, and with all of the setbacks that you have to have for the town, you know, however many meters from the rear lot line, how many from the sides, you know, I think we had to be at least 4 feet from the side property lines, had to be back so far from the front property line, and being able to do all of those different setbacks meant that the footprint that I wanted for the house to have enough space, living space and garage space to tinker, meant that we were going to have to go for an adjustment to the basically asking for a variance and going to the variance committee for or committee of adjustments to be able to approve the variance that we wanted, because we wanted more space than what was typically allowed by the bylaws. That opened up a very interesting journey back and forth. You know, it was a lot of, you know, since I'm in this older part of Milton, there's a lot of heritage studies that have been going along and wanting to make sure that the character of the home met in with what the neighborhood had. And some of those different things in there, we had to kind of work and back and forth with the city on. You know, character wasn't necessarily the look and feel of the house. It could have been modern. They made very clear it wasn't the look of the home, but it was, you know, how high was it? What was its massing? What did its, you know, the number of garages on the face of the house, what would that look like in that area compared to everything else? And so what came back out of that whole process was, number one, is we couldn't set our garage faces all the way up to the front of where the front of the house was. The setbacks for your garage face had to be another 5 feet back from what the front of the house was allowed to be on. So we had to, you know, push those garage faces back. The other one was that, you know, the three bays just really wasn't gonna cut it for being able to be conducive to the neighborhood. So we took one of the kind of a section of one of those different bays and made it into kind of a utility and a foyer. And it actually turned out better that way, that there's a place to come in when you, you know, came in either from the garage or came in from the front door to be able to hang your coat, a place for the utility room, You know, other different things, another bathroom on that main floor. So if I'm working, I can come straight in and use the bathroom and not have to go all the way upstairs to use that. But we were able to still maintain a workshop space, a space, or basically a single car garage space behind that. So I still had three bays about of actual physical space to work on vehicles. Now, my depth got shrunk by 5 feet, which it would have been nice to have that extra 5 feet for tooling, for benches and things like that, that I would have had more space in there. But I got to work within the constraints that we had. So we came back and revised our plans with all of those changes in there. So now there's this kind of cantilevered stuff where Olivia's bedroom is cantilevered over top of this area below, and the garage space is pushed back in, and we have this window on the other side. So one of these things is, I think, you know, things happen for a reason. As we've been doing these adjustments, I think it came out even better of a visual appearance of the house. So that meant things that we could do, things like move the laundry room. We had laundry closet in the upstairs. We could move that down into the utilities and reuse that space, and allowed us to kind of reconfigure how we were doing the master bathroom and the main floor bathroom, and all the spacing that we had. So final design, really, really excited with it. We're getting close to being able to submit for permits, and I'll do a video just a little bit about what's involved in permitting to get everything ready for that. This sense of windows, this sense of space, of course for me, I like to tinker, so I had to get out Google SketchUp and actually create full-on 3D models of the house, the floor plan, the heights, so I could get a sense of what the space is going to look like. What would my kitchen look like? How would a modern kitchen look? What are the different renderings of those? So of course I get a plug-in to SketchUp to be able to do full-on, almost photographic renders of different places to get a sense of the texture and the light and the surfaces. Do I want glossy cabinets or not? And started doing some of those to get a real feel of the house. So really we got to a point of where I'm really happy now with the amount of space that I have to work on my projects. I have a great kind of this neat looking house that's a little bit different than what you would usually see. And like I said, anybody that knows me, that's kind of my thing. I like just doing something a little bit strange or different, but it came across really cool with all of the different angles. So likely going to be going with a combination of stone, some it's called Luxiclad, it's like a fake wood, and then stucco on the building. So that was kind of like the design process to get there. It was a lot of fun. I can say that the whole going through the committee of adjustments and getting that approval was a little nerve-wracking. It did set back. I was hoping to be able to start kind of getting things breaking ground in the fall of 2020, but we had to kind of go through all of those different adjustments. We had to get approved. We finally got our plans approved at the end of October. So now we've just been finalizing and working on all the mechanical things and stuff for the permits that I'll cover in another video. But that's kind of the process. I'm really, really happy that I was able to find Gabriel on being able to come up with that design. And so kind of the next part is permitting and construction, and being really happy to be able to work with my friend Antonio from Buildbucks to be able to do the construction on the home. He helped me out with a condo and helped me out with other projects in the past. So really excited to get construction started with his company. But that's where we are so far. Next part is permitting, we'll be able to kind of talk a little bit about what some of the struggles and some of the tweaks that I still need to kind of get finished off there in order to get that permit submitted. So thanks a lot for watching. Hopefully, there's a little bit of information in here that might be helpful if others are kind of going through the same process, and hope to see you in the next video.